Welcome to Fresh Take. This is the show where we give you the hottest tracks from the freshest artists. You're with me, Edward, and today is an episode like no other because we have three unique guests coming onto the show. Now, we have a singer and songwriter in Leanne Kyla, as well as a hip-hop artist in Critico. But starting off and getting the ball rolling in today's episode, we have the neo-soul and gospel vibes of Alan and Elle. Fresh Tech stage, we got Alan and Elle. Hello, guys.
Hello.
Hello. I'm so happy that you're here as well. Tell us first and foremost about that song that you just sang, Promise.
So basically, Promise is actually a different song for us. It's like our first time making neo soul type of song. And just a fun fact, because I was the one who produced it, our inspiration for that song when I was producing it is K-pop, actually.
Wow.
Because a lot of people may be surprised, but we get a lot of inspirations from different genres because we believe that it's effective to make creative and wonderful music when you combine different genres. But when it comes to the message of the song, Alan was the one who wrote it.
I wrote the song, Promise. So it's basically about expressing the feeling of being in love. Yeah, so it's like just when you're in love with someone, you just want to say I promise and things like that. And it was really fun writing that song because when I was writing that song, I was actually thinking about what will I tell the Lord if he's in front of me? What will I tell him? Because as a gospel songwriter, that's my inspiration. So yeah, I was like thinking, what will I say? How can I express that feeling of being in love with him? And yeah, that's basically the song.
Well, it seems like it's really a good combination what you guys have going here. Inspirations from different genres, but the core message is the same. So tell us about the heart and soul of all your music.
When we began making music together as Alan and Elle, we made it a point to portray a message. What kind of message are we going to tell everybody? And we thought of course, we wanted something that's very meaningful to us, which is our faith. So all our, if you listen to all our songs, everything is actually about God. And especially when Alan's writing it, she bases it from verses.
Yeah,
awesome.
Yeah. Exactly. So, but we also kept in mind how everybody, all listeners, anywhere, we all have different beliefs, and that's okay. So our very message is just to share our love for God and to share a universal language, which is love.
Love through music.
Through music. So,
through music. Yeah. The one true, pure type of love.
Exactly.
I love that. I love that a lot. But you had this one post. And I'm just going to make sure I read it because I want to make sure I get it right. It says, what would you do if the love that you give isn't being reciprocated? So, parang one-sided love. What do you guys, what's your answer to that? What do we do if that's our situation?
Well, for me, surrender it to God because you can't control a lot of things. You can't control other people's feelings and, you know, in the circumstance. So just surrender. Although it's hard, but eventually through His love and through love and loving yourself, you'll get through it. So,
you'll get through it.
And that's, that line is actually from our song, You. And for me, what would I do if the love that I give isn't reciprocated? Well, of course, I've experienced that before.
I'm sorry.
Hindi lang naman, syempre, with the heartbreak stuff. Syempre, it could be about friends and family. And like Alan, I'd also surrender it. I'll give time for myself to feel the pain, of course, because it happens and it's normal. But at the same time, I will shield myself and prepare myself with prayers and just, you know, just surrender everything.
Amen.
Yeah.
Of course, like at the end of the day, we always remember that if you don't get what you think you need, there's always one source of love that will never, ever, ever run out. Everyone watching right now, if you guys want a little bit of rest, just listen to this song. Check it out. We'll be right back. are joined by the singer, songwriter, and someone with a rich history here in the industry as well, Leanne Kyla. Ooh. Hi, Leanne.
Hey, Edward. How are you?
I'm doing very well. I'm happy that you're here on the show. I guess you could say I am masaya.
Yes.
I'm happy. Like, your song is called Saya.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us, what is that song all about? I'm sure major self-explanatory nga siya, but what's the inspiration behind the song?
Yeah, so the inspiration behind that song was a real-life experience. Mm-hmm. And it's based around that idea of when you meet somebody for the first time and you have all sorts of, like, indescribable feelings inside of you, like butterflies, and you're kind of nervous and scared and anxious at the same time. So it's kind of like finding that journey of, like, dealing with all those feelings and ultimately deciding, now, oh, I'm happy. This person makes me happy. So, yeah.
My gosh. So for you, why did you choose this craft and this industry as the place you wanted to call home?
I think for me, being in the music industry was something that I fell into. Mm-hmm. Or it was something that called to me, I guess, in a way. Yeah, I'd always loved singing. My dream used to be on Broadway. So that was my...
Okay.
Yeah, I wanted to do theater. And then I never imagined writing my own songs. But one day I started just, like, posting covers on YouTube. And then Sir Jonathan Manalo noticed.
The one and only.
The one and only Sir Jonathan Manalo. And then he reached out and he was like, hey, you wanna try this? And then I just said yes to that opportunity. And then I kept saying yes to the next opportunities.
What mark do you want to leave on the industry? What do you want to change, if anything?
Maybe I don't necessarily want to make a huge impact.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to find my sound, be myself, and in doing so, maybe be able to touch some people's lives.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully be able to help other people find their sound as well.
Well, there are a lot of people watching right now, and I'm sure amongst those are yung mga up-and-coming artists who are trying to find themselves, trying to find who they are and their identity. So for you, first of all, how did you find your image as Leanne Kyla?
I think I'm still in the process of finding it. And I think it's just not being afraid to try something new. I think that's it. And to honor whatever it is that you want to try. Because some people maybe are afraid of going outside their box.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm always somebody who embraces that sort of, like, curiosity and that willingness to experiment. So that's what I'd encourage other people to do also.
Yeah. Galing, no? When people ask why, you say why not.
Yes.
Sino-sino ba ang tama? Sino-sino ang mali? Panginoon, isa lamang po ang aking dalangin. Ako po'y bigyan ng pagkakataon, hindi ko sasayang.
Can we just meet at 2 a.m.?
Kasharianiria. Siguro po sa akin, sa araw-araw yung pagluluto habang nag-freestyle, kasi yun talaga yung ginagawa ko, lalo na ngayon na nasa bahay lang tayo. Yung kulitan namin ng baby ko, kasi nakikita ko siya everyday kung paano siya matuto ng mga bagay-bagay. So yun yung talaga nagpapa-fresh sa akin.
Alright, we have one of the best, I guess you could say, lyricists, wordsmiths, rhymesmiths in the business here in the Philippines. We got Critico, everybody! Hello, Critico. Hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Grabe. Yung pangalan mo, Critico, of course, to be a critic. Hindi naman masama ang pagiging critic. Pero ikaw ba, Critico? Are you your biggest critic?
Siguro, madagdag ko lang. Yung Critico kasi dati talaga na nag-aaral pa ako, siguro mga nasa elementary ako nun. Ni-research ko siya and nalaman ko yung meaning niya. Yun nga, sabi ko, ito ang astig ng pangalan na to. Hanggang sa dulo na hindi ko alam na ito na pala yung magiging buhay ko talaga. Ang paggawa ng paglikha ng rap music. So sabi ko, panindigan ko na tong Critico, hindi para maging criticize ng kung ano-ano, kundi para tumingin or pumigil or umawat sa mga maling nangyayari, 'di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Bilang isang, sabi natin, hindi bilang artist or bilang isang tao mamamayan, may karapatan tayong i-criticize ang bawat maling nangyayari.
Totoo.
So yun para sa akin. Yun yung pangalan ko na dapat panindigan ko at dapat gawin ko.
Galing. Of course, kailangan din natin, di lang dito sa Pilipinas, pero worldwide, yung voice of reason and yung voice of truth, that yun ang meron sa'yo. So we love that as well. Pero binanggit mo kayo kung paano mo nahanap ang name mo or yung stage name mo. Paano ka ba nag-umpisa bilang rapper?
Sa totoo lang, hindi talaga dapat ako rapper ngayon eh. Kasi yung nanay ko makulit, nag-aral niya ako ng medicine kahit ayoko.
Wow.
So nung bata pa ako, palagi akong nakakarinig doon sa mga kalapit naming bahay mga nagra-rap sila, mga grupo-grupo. So, and nung mga panahon na yun, marami rin pagka may piyesta sa amin, pagka may mga, kung ano-ano mang okasyon, may mga sumasali or sumasalang doon na nagra-rap. Sabi ko, parang ang astig na na. Then, yun na, narinig ko yung kantang Itsumo. Then yun, kinabisado ko siya hanggang sa, kaya ko palang sumabay sa flow. Yes, kaya kong sumabay sa beat. Tapos, hanggang kalaunan, sabi ko, try ko magsulat. Tapos yun na po, tuloy-tuloy na, dire-diretso na. Hanggang sa yun, nakita ko na yung sarili ko na, ah, ito pala yung buhay ko. Para dito pala ako.
Galing, no? Ito, kilalang-kilala mo yung industry, yung hip-hop industry as well, sa loob ng OPM. And ang daming underground artists. At doon talaga, parang doon talaga nagsimula ang hip-hop. Para sa'yo, ano ba yung tatak Pinoy sa hip-hop?
Yung mga artists kasi dito, kung ano yung nararanasan nila sa buhay, yun yung nilalagay nila sa kanta. Mm-hmm. Kung ano yung nararamdaman nila, yun yung nilalagay nila sa kanta. Nire-represent nila yung sarili nila dun sa song. So para sa akin, yung pagiging totoo ng mga artists dito sa Pinas, yun yung pinagkaiba natin sa iba.
Yeah. At lagi may kwento yung,
yes, totoo, yung
mga kanta natin. So balita ko, itong kakantain mo is part of a trilogy as well. So tell us about that, itong 2AM, this song.
Itong song na to, sobrang bawal. Kumbaga para sa akin nga, ito yung ano, lihim at pinagbabawal na pag-ibig.
Wow.
Para bigyan kayo ng konting preview dun sa song. Ano siya, 2AM, kasi yun yung oras na nagkikita sila.
Oh gosh.
Silang dalawa. Yung dito kasi, yung character ng babae dito, meron siyang karelasyon na iba. Then ako yung nagsulat, kumbaga ako yung character na lalaki, nagkikita kami kahit meron na siyang karelasyon. So yun.
Oh, ang sakit na yan, bro. Okay, but of course, Forbidden Love nga ito. And sabi mo nga, it's here written sa lyrics, hindi mali magmahal, pero kailan ba dapat bumitaw? So para sa'yo, ano yung borderline kung sa point na yan, kailangan bumitaw ka na?
Hindi masamang magmahal. Sobrang hindi masamang magmahal. Dahil ang pagmamahal, binibigay talaga yan. Pero kung alam mo nang dahil sa pagmamahal na yan, makakasakit ka, or meron kang isang relasyong masisira, o meron kang isang pamilyang masisira, hanggat maaga pa, itigil mo na. Kasi sa huli, masasaktan ka na, mali ka ba?
Oh my gosh. If you're listening, and you're in that, ilam mo na, this is the advice of Critico, itigil mo na, stop it now. But the ball is gonna keep on rolling, we're gonna keep the show going. Here is Critico with his song, 2AM.
Masyadong mangamba, ihahatid kita bago pa makahalata sila. Alam mo bang miss na kita? Lalo na ang ganda ng mata mo't labing mapula.
Huwag kang mag-alala kung ano mang mangyayari sa atin lamang tong dalawa. Ibang iba pag nasa'yo, nawawala ako sa mundo. Alam mo ang aking gusto, kaya kahit hindi wasto, ako'y di lalayo sa'yo. Maliwanag na ang paligid, totoo ang mga kalang, di ako nananaginip. Sa iyo ay nakatitig kahit pilit kong pigilin, ako na ay umiibig.
Alam na kung anong dapat gawin,
kahit mali,
sundin natin hanggang sa marating.
Can we just meet at 2 a.m.?
Cause shawty I need ya.
Can we just meet at 2 a.m.?
Shawty I need ya.
Nating gawin.
Alam na kung anong dapat gawin,
kahit mali,
sundin natin hanggang sa marating.
Can we just meet at 2 a.m.?
Cause shawty I need ya.
Can we just meet at 2 a.m.
So shawty, I need ya now.
What a show, of course. Sadly, it is the end of this episode of Fresh Take. And in the studio right here to the side, we actually got Critico. We got Alan and Ellen. We got Lee and Kyla as well. And to the three of you, or four of you, thank you so much for coming on the show. But I actually want to come back to that one question I asked Alan and Elle a while ago. What do you do if the love that you give so freely is actually not being reciprocated? Well, my answer, my thoughts on that question is keep on giving it and get the love that you truly deserve and need from the source himself. I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next episode of Fresh Take. This has been Edward Barber. Peace out.